Tina, Tina, your coach. The first game, Tina to serve, the ball.
Well, let's see. Dina Meshref will start with the serve. These two have never played head-to-head before, not according to the ITTF records of the World Tour. Here we go.
Right. Love ball.
Much more aggressive start than in the first match. Partika with the big opening backhand to the middle. So Dina forced into slightly more passive play when the side spin came in. Still hasn't had a chance to make a big opening yet. At least hasn't initiated. Good shot here from Partika, catches the edge of the table, but goes for the line. Walks away with the point. We saw the soft flicks earlier with Ellie Samara. I still wonder if there was something with the back of Ellie Samara. Had a chance to watch her other match as well, and I've definitely seen her in better form, so I'm guessing there's something that's slowing her down a little bit at the moment.
One, four.
Near edge of the table. Creates a gift serve for Natalia Partika. I'm still waiting to be commentating a match where someone serves it into their edge and their opponent's edge for an ace. So with the first towel break here, Dina within 2 points. Maybe still warming up a bit to the style of Natalia Partika, who for me I think is going to be more and more aggressive. Partika was just asked, is that your coach in the corner? I think he showed up a little bit later, maybe. So they needed clarification. Is that guy who took the seat in the corner? Better placement here. Meshref inside the table, finds the wide forehand. Been a deep level of focus and even, I'd say, some tension from Natalia Partika. Of course, seeing her face after losing a point, you might not see the cheery, smiley, satisfied side. But a lot of pressure here. Remember, this is to see who continues in the tournament and who's out on day one. Good extra spin here for Meshref. Partika knows to stay closed, but overcompensates a bit. Dina can spin the ball like that, keep it low to the net. It's going to accelerate away from the net, put a bit of extra pressure on her opponent.
Six, five.
Again, Coach Necek. Zbigniew. Three-time national team coach, 9 years with Natalia Partika.
Six all.
Again, it feels very gritty right now in terms of the fight for points. Not going to see a ton of long exchanges out here so far. And I think that could just be a style thing. Partika's got the power when she gets the opponent behind the table. The heavy spin, and both players are looking to end the point quickly.
Six, seven.
And when the pace comes in, if Dina is able to counter back and win the points, It's going to be very effective, I'd say, from a mental standpoint, to remind her that she's equipped for even if the opponent can make the first strong move. That's a good position to be in. Not feeling like you're escaping on serve and touch game alone. You can handle a variety of situations from the opponent. And covering the middle as well, Dina up by one. Dina has a rich family history of table tennis excellence. Her mother, a bit of a legendary pro before. Father, quite involved. Younger brother actually playing. And a nice flick here, a little bit of bend to it. Takes it deep to the corner. But as far as I know, Dina has really outperformed all her family members by a landslide. Again, anybody in the history of Africa, any women in the game, Dina sets the bar.
Turn seven.
And now it is three game points. The Queen of Africa, Egypt's own Dina Meshref, to take game one. Well prepared, finds the crossover point deep in the backhand corner, gets a bit of hesitation out of Partika and takes game one 11-7. Meshref up 1-0, will be back for game two and the fight to stay alive in the tournament coming up right after this. Back for game number two, Natalia Partika with the serve down 0-1. First point of every game, she's been aggressive, started off quite strong against Dina in game one, taking what, the first 3 points?
One all.
Edge of the racket and the quick counter. Dina is very strong. Again, having trained in China, playing quite well. I mean, she's playing on the world tour as regularly as almost anybody right now. And I think she said Germany is where she's playing this year. She's playing her first time in the league. This is something we hear from players all over the world. There is no Chinese Super League this year, and while there are commercial leagues around that have some top players, in terms of training and club play, German League, one of over 20 European leagues that, well, often sends teams to the Champions League. A great opportunity for players around the world. People often ask how to turn pro, and it's a long process and it's not easy, but finding a club to train, it takes you in when you're young, definitely helps. I think I see a Singaporean world champion in the background there.
A
lot of active coaching from the corner on Natalia Partika's side. First towel break, dead even once again. That world champion in the orange hoodie, I think you'll have a chance to see Li Jiawei. Helped Singapore to the 2010 World Championships, if I'm not mistaken.
4-3.
That was over China, mind you, Feng Tianwei.
Three fight.
Again, a little trouble with the fuller swing connecting, turning to cover the middle with the forehand. Ref apologizing for hitting the umpire there with a quick ball off the edge of the racket, obviously unintentional.
Four.
So a three-point lead here for Dina Meshref. Just a reminder of the level of play here. Again, you've got 20 women qualified from continental competitions. Well, a few qualified, for example, Liu Shiwan is world champion. So I guess 18 qualified. The other one is a wild card, Lily Zhang from the United States, competing on the next table now. Again, fighting for her chance to continue in the tournament. But I was looking down the list of past winners, and in the final, Elisabetta Samara of 2012, she played the final against Liu Shiwan, one of the four times that Liu Shiwan has taken the title.
Fault nine.
I'd be curious to see what happens if Partika serves a little shorter to the forehand of Meshref. In terms of getting something long to open with. And a break off the top of the net after serving shorter to the forehand. Seemed that she was curious as well. 6 game points for a 2-0 lead for Dina Meshref. Quality opening spin though from Partika saves game point. Heavy spin in the bottom of the net. Meshref catching the very end of the head of the racket to get massive spin on that ball. We'll talk about that more in game number 3. Dina Meshref up 2-0. Back for game 3 right after this. Back for game number 3. Dina Meshref with the serve up 2-0. Partika looking for some answers. None found just yet. Not enough. Oh, Meshref recovers quickly and finds the opposite corner. Again, the pressure coming in right now. The pace on the ball. Dina's just the faster in terms of efficiency and strokes.
one. Oh.
They both had their share of rallies ending with an edge ball, though, off the edge of the racket. It's quite amazing it doesn't happen even more often, considering how closed the rackets are when pros come into the ball. Perfect shot, shortens it up a little bit in terms of the length on the table, goes to the middle. This happened late in the match earlier for Natalia Partica, taking a bit more risk. For me in general, the underdog has to take more chances.
1-3.
Now these two, despite their world rankings, just because of the continental difference, I would expect to be quite close. So it's really tough to say one is a underdog or favorite over the other, especially as they've never played before, not on the world tour.
1-4.
Great idea here from Eshref. Come around the outside of the ball, bend it wide to the forehand. Parallel here, quick off the bounce. Again, the speed game, Dina Meshref getting faster and faster. Since I started watching the Women's World Cups live and commentating them, I've seen her develop over the years. I've seen her pull off several good wins. Good three, I think. And at the Women's World Cup, a win, I mean, you're looking at the cream of the crop. In theory, you go to the continents that maybe aren't quite as packed, densely packed with top players, and even still, players that are quite tough to beat. One after another, corner to corner, Meshref finally beating the footwork of Partica. See that acceleration, how she uses the wrist there, keeps it back until the point of contact. Just before, obviously. Well, now, I rarely see this serve used. It's one of my favorite serves personally. Top and side spin from the backhand, the kicker. See how she varies it up, or if she varies it up here. Well read from Partica, but in the rallies, Dina's too consistent right now. She's playing the angles well while she's had her edge shots from time to time. She didn't have an easy first ball, had to get the racket up high in front of the body to recover. That's the apology there for a little clip off the net.
Timeout.
Timeout. Partica's side, after a decent lead, was not only recovered, but then Dina Meshref took the lead from Partica. Still 1 point between them. So half a minute left on the scoreboard, excuse me, the clock. Wow, it's amazing what happens if you sleep 0 minutes. Good times. On that note, 6-5 Dina Meshref with 2-0. I was going to say that Partica is a strong player, but so far this tournament, her opponents have really not let you see that. Her opponents have been stronger in the rallies, have shut down the game in terms of over-the-table play. There have been a few players here, and this could just be the nature of playing some of the top players in the world, that look quite strong normally, and here just never really found their rhythm. Had a chance to chat with Adriana Diaz on the break. She was in good spirits, but we both agreed that we've seen her play better.
Six all.
So out of the timeout, coming into the towel break here, Partica again, there just seems to be not a real sense of calm or in the zone right now. That could be a very personal thing. It's interesting talking with the Chinese national team, or about the Chinese national team for that matter, in terms of not showing frustration.
7-6.
This idea that you can't show any weakness. The mesh ref shoes, shiny and black.
Seven all.
Some crucial points here. Again, it'll take a lot of work for Parchika, but if she can take this game, changes the pressure on Meshref, gives a bit of confidence to a player who, as we've seen, seems to not be finding her rhythm exactly. And a heavy spin serve, a bit more central on the table. Now this looks more like the Partika that I know. Mid-distance, getting low, spinning and driving, moving around. I feel like she's just been trying to stay close to the table. The winner, 63 kilometers per hour. I'm curious to see what the clock will say when we get Lucia One out here. Edge of the table here for Meshref. A little bit more fortune. Not too much imbalance, though.
My all.
Following the serve with the attack, Dina now at 9-9 with Natalia Partika. These are the pressure moments. Look at the spin on that winner. We saw some serves that were about a third of that spin. And serves are often about spin. Although sometimes taking spin off the ball, but that'd be interesting to see a stat where it's like, instead of 1700 or 5500, it's like 33 RPM. And now game point for Partika, second serve to follow. Partika taking her time here. Drying the ball, wants to make sure that she has a clear head about what she's gonna set up and how she's gonna set it up. Third ball forehand, I think, would be ideal for her. Meshref keeps it inside the table and shuts down the attack. Takes away the third ball. Looks like Partika is getting a yellow card. Interesting. Well, I guess we're showing the frustration and kicking the ball back towards the barrier. We shall see. 10 points apiece. Missing the timing here.
11, 10.
It's tough after a strawberry and an opening attack, but Dina with a soft block leaves it slightly out in front of Partika, forcing her to move in. Again, not a very fast winner. 38 kilometers per hour. That was about barely more than half of one of the last winners we saw. Game point for Meshref.
11, all.
The spin generated on that serve has been trouble for several of Partika's opponents, but they tend to adjust relatively quickly. The ball at the top of the net one more time for Dina Meshref. But it wasn't the winning shot, it was before in the rally. Clean shot to win it. Game point Meshref.
Five all.
Sometimes we've seen Partica with their back against the ropes, finding a bit of courage, playing a bit more risky. The vocalization, I feel like it's definitely for herself. It's her way of saying, be strong, you can do this. Sometimes it's tough when you're not making the shots that you're used to making or feel like you should make. Fourth towel break, both players remaining at the table. Seems like most of those serves keep top spin and side spin on, but varying amounts. This has a bit more side spin than the first one we saw from Metra. We got our 33, but it was in the speed department, not the spin department. Game point, Partica. Fishing rally, 22 shots, and it was a long game, but 14 points to 12. And Natalia Partica is on the scoreboard with the game. We'll be back for game four as the plot thickens and the match continues for the fight for survival to see who will move on to the main draw. Dina Meshref, Natalia Partica, stay right here to find out. Game four coming up after this. Players back for game four. Dina Meshref still up 2-1. You saw where Natalia Partica was placing the ball in the rallies, drilling the middle, trying to get Dina Meshref to turn and play a forehand. A little bit late or uncomfortably. See how she uses the serve here to set up her attacks.
One lob.
Curious, we've seen service warnings for verticality and occasionally for not very high toss serves. Ding Ning at the Olympics in 2012 was faulted for the service toss not rising high enough out of the hand. It fell plenty, but it was tossed from a high point. I bring that up because when I watch Natalia Partica's toss, I think that's got to be pretty close. And especially if umpires are being a little bit stricter, I'd be curious to see if they call her for that. In the service game of Partica, and she serves middle of the table more. This one was longer, but the amount of rotation on her serve has often had receivers pushing the ball wide, the spin carrying the ball off the table. Meshref comes in over, takes the backhand inside. Again, for those of you curious why you see players step in over the table for the backhand so much more when it's on the forehand side, because there's more flexibility in the wrist on the backhand. It's a more compact stroke that needs less backswing. so you can generate an aggressive shot from inside the table.
3-4.
Sounded a bit like back edge, but no apologies, so maybe clean. I've seen plenty of replays where I thought, oh, thought that hit the edge. I think it did ever so slightly. Nice change of pattern here. 2 out wide to the forehand. But a much quicker time on the second one. First one was the big spin one to know she'd get the ball back long and then move in over the table, a pattern we saw from Patricia Solia earlier today quite frequently.
5-4.
Nice change of placement here. Partika short to the forehand, mixing it up. An important thing will be to keep Dina Meshref guessing. Occasionally a long serve the other way. Down the middle of the table on top of the bounce. It was just the pendulum serve this time. Change of rotation. A little bit more central on the table. Strongest performance yet. Partika barely edging it out last game, but now with double the score of her opponent, a 4-point lead at the second towel break, she's finding a way to get Dina a little bit behind the table, guessing a little bit more. And for me, the short game, the first two shots in the rally, when she's on the receive, she's been a bit stronger, but watch her service game as well. Middle of the table, short forehand.
8-5.
Even if Dina goes for the flick, it's going to be most likely middle of the table or forehand for Partika. She's going to be, I'd say, pretty comfortable to counter that. It's been tough for Dina to get a very strong opening with the forehand. At least on receiving short serves.
6-8.
Step in here, catches the ball high, plays it down the line. Partika taking advantage of an opportunity that she earned. Soft touch shot inside the table. Less rotation on the first one. Spin rate on the last one and speed as well. 57 kilometers per hour.
I don't think so.
So there's a disagreement here. We'll watch it in slow motion. Did it bounce twice? She went for it for sure. Second bounce. Replay, we get to know. So Dina Meshref was right. The call was right by the umpire.
Nice seven.
Wow, it's amazing how sometimes video replay, when it comes in, is going to be so helpful for many things. Dina handled it with a lot of class, as she always does. I think it was double bounce. I mean, how easy would it have been to say, for sure no, for sure that was two bounces? I think we've all felt that way before. You were sure of something. 72 kilometers per hour here inside the table. 3 game points for Partika. The fastest backhands we've seen from Partika yet. A well-played point, and Meshref right on top of the bounce for every one of the speed shots. Playing him safely. Covers the middle with the backhand, covers the deep backhand as well. Quite efficient counter game. Blocking game from Dina. But still adding a bit of pace just to keep the pressure on. Couldn't play too passively there. Two game points left for Partika on the receive. Backhand to backhand, she does it. Getting faster and stronger. Partika with a bit of momentum takes game number four. It's tied up at 2-2, and we'll see who takes the lead in game number five. Coming up right after this.
Match eight to serve, drop ball.
So this is where things get tricky. Natalia Partika has some confidence now. She's playing stronger near the table. Backhand's been effective.
What luck?
Dina Meshref, after being up 2-0 and nearly 3-0, nearly 3-0, 14-12 in game number three. Now dead even.
Love two.
This is something that professionals are quite good at, though, not dwelling on the past. Realizing no point in stressing about something they can't change. Just playing the next point.
Love three. Yep.
Strong start for Meshref, not a point dropped so far in the backhand-to-backhand exchange neither. Funny thing is, Meshref for me, on both wings, has good versatility in terms of the spin game, the speed game. For example, in this rally, gets a big forehand to open, and as soon as the ball comes back quickly, her racket's up and ready for the block. That was the last shot of the rally, obviously. Gave a thumbs up to the opponent, said yes, quality ball coming in.
Go!
Strawberry and a wide chop block. Outstanding spin, and Meshref with the soft hands controls it, keeps it on the table, and forces Partika to deal with the spin she left on the ball. When someone loads something that heavy with spin, it's a natural reaction to play it defensively. And it's often a lot to deal with. Shovel serve goes long. A gift for Meshref to extend her lead by one.
Seven, one.
Tough score line here. Always makes me think of Feng Tianwei at the Japan Open in 2014. think down 0-7, scores 11 in a row.
Seven, pool.
Technique just perfect there on that opening backhand. No question, she's not happy about that. Choosing to play it softly, just try and fish it up. The first one, a baby strawberry, a little bit of side spin on it, something to make it uncomfortable potentially. Force smash ref to really recalibrate.
Line.
There it is, the rocket backhand. Partika, since game number three, has been turning up the heat on that backhand, gaining confidence. Still, she's down by six at the second towel break. If she can find this for the rest of the match, though, play these loose, wristy backhands. To have that high of a speed and that high of a spin, I mean, that's just the textbook perfect backhand.
My fault.
Spin on the receive and right into the corner game from the backhand corner, turning after the opening backhand here. So Partika's already used her timeout. Dina Meshref has not. I think if Partika scores one more point, we will see that timeout. The timeout, here it is. A little conversation. The experience in the corner.
Time out.
So for Dina Meshref, the backhand to backhand exchange, when she goes one corner to corner, I think we saw earlier today, Partika did have a little trouble going wide to the backhand and then the opposite corner.
Okay. So yes,
he's trying to listen, assuming Arabic was the language in the corner with Dina Meshref's coach. And I heard she yet and realized it was for someone else bringing in water. Dina Meshref speaks a little bit of Mandarin as well, actually. A lot of her family does. Her mother does, too, from having trained in China for years. Or over the years, not for straight years, as far as I know. But making regular habits of it. Something that we hear from a good percentage of the pros around the world. Whether it's a month at a time, 6 weeks, or just a 2 week camp, can be quite eye opening. The work ethic, the standard. So back from the timeout, second serve here for Partika. The reverse pendulum, it's a top spin into the middle for Dina Meshref that earns 4 game points. And the perfect length serve 11, sneaks six. Under the racket. A bit of backspin to help the ball bite and stay shallow. Dina Meshref takes it 11-6. It's a 3-2 lead, one game away from getting herself a spot in the main draw. Partika will fight game number 6 coming up right after this.
Потім буде вона починає на дефензивну, і ось стане перша зміна. Z dużym spokojem. Blisko na nogach wróć nieruchomości. Niech się tak kończy. Nie ma przetrzymania. Długie akcje są twoje. Ona zabywa tym też krótkich akcji. Długie są twoje. Serwis na nią masz. Odbierasz, odbierasz. Teraz tylko trzymaj.
The sixth game, Partikar to serve, love all.
So players back for game six. Natalia Partika down 2-3, but not too far out of reach. We could be looking at a decider situation. Off the top of the net here again. The fortune has favored Dina Meshref so far in this match. The last game, 11-6. Quite a dominant performance. Contact again. The timing has been a little bit of an issue, at least in the early parts of the match, more so. We've seen when Partika was moved in and out. Again, the Japanese national team will set up cameras to film people to see how they move not only side to side, but how well they do in and out. It's an important part of the game. Wow. I think Dina Meshref must have just done so many good things for other people. The universe is like, you know what, Dina? You deserve it. Think about all the kind things you've done. Maybe just today alone, you deserve 8 net balls in this match.
Like, love falls.
Pretty high level of gratitude. That's a backhand that doesn't come back. A long serve, Dina seemed well prepared for it. Partika knew the ball would be coming back long. 6,300, over 6,300 RPM. And this is an example of out in front. Don't know if it clipped the net on the way over, and that's what the apology was for, and why the ball was left out in front. Scoreline similar to last game before Partika started to turn things around. It's tough when you're playing a match and you realize not only is your back against the ropes for the match, but this is to stay in the tournament. It's day one, but it's tough. I mean, 20 of the best in the world. Back edge of the table for Dina Meshref. Yeah, Partika told as well.
8-1.
Did the right thing as she's done throughout the day. A very faint edge here, just a little clip, you could hear it. Partika in the middle of the table there to cover the wide forehand. Less room for Meshref to sneak it past. Good parallel forehand here. A long way to go, but not too long. And while Meshref is definitely closer to the end of this match, Partika's within 5, made her comeback last game, showed that she could play under pressure. The extra spin on the last ball, and Meshref on top of the bounce sets herself up with a 6-point lead at the second towel break. Junji, he is watching this match very closely as well. And now 7 game and match points for Dina Meshref to move on to the main draw. Would not be the first time for a 7-time Women's World Cup participant. Match points saved. Partika still hanging on.
Like, 10-4.
The step around, Partika after a fast backhand exchange. I mean, mentally in my head, I'm already thinking Dina Meshref has won this rally so many times, backhand to backhand. That's the match. Partika, nope. Stays in the rally and says, okay, maybe I've got to get out of the backhand to backhand rally. Dina's won too many of these. I'm bringing out the forehand to finish the rally. Oh, and an edge again for Dina Meshref. She saves it. You can see how sincerely she feels embarrassed and bad about the way it happened, but she played an outstanding match. She was in position, she was fast, she was well prepared in the serve and the receive, backhand to backhand rallies, and here, even from behind the table, an undying effort. And the Queen of Africa moves on over Natalia Partika of Poland. Congratulations, Dina Meshref. No matter how it happened out here today, you played an outstanding match. You deserve it. Natalia Partika, tough day. It'll be tough to see you go, but we look forward to seeing you more on the World Tour. That was a look back at the coach for Dina Meshref to say we did it. We survived the tough opponent. 4-2. Game number 3, Partika really getting back in with a 2-game streak. But Dina showing how strong she could be from the start of games 5 and 6. Here's a look at the placement on the table. 4. I'm going to go Dina Meshref's placement. Nope, Natalia Partika. I tried to use my Mandarin to say it'd be really helpful if we could see the name before the numbers and whatnot. So there you go. Make of that what you will, Natalia Partika. 2 left-handed players, so deep to the backhand and middle of the table in the rally. These are the places to go. Stick around. We've got another match coming up in just a bit. It should be exciting. It's Wu Yue versus Mo Zhang. The North Americans battle it out. Stay right here.